Hello everyone, what's your YouTube center? Welcome back. Igamalamdum Asisithi Sejosengoe and welcome back again. It is so nice to say Molweni bantu base YouTube center. I have not said that since November last year. So I took a break and initially I thought that I would come back in January, but then I was just so tired. I decided let me take an extra month to sort of relax and gather myself, gather my energy so that when I come back, I don't come back and be inconsistent. So today I'm gonna do a little bit of a life update and sort of catch you up on what are the plans for the channel for the rest of the year and what am I up to, what are some of the plans and what are some of my goals. So life update. 2021, hey, it has brought a few changes in our family home. My sister no longer lives with us. She got a job and has left, and she left in I think at the beginning of February. So the whole month of February that I was supposed to come back here and start producing content was the month that I had to start adjusting to her not being here. And Bali was still staying with us at the time, so I practically had two kids, a husband and a house to run, and that was quite tiring and exhausting. So I spent much of my February actually trying to catch my breath, because now it meant that all the responsibilities that my sister had, they were now mine on top of the ones that I already had. And if you guys know anything about my schedule, it is pretty tight. So I had to sort of like do a bit of readjusting here and there, take out some of the stuff that were not very necessary at the point, and unfortunately YouTube was one of them. So that when I do come back and start adding things in my schedule, I am not feeling so overwhelmed. So I was extremely tired in February. And yeah, you know, sometimes you would think that when someone is here, you don't really need their help, or you don't really see what they're doing. And once they're gone, you're like, oh my gosh, these are some of the things you did. And I did have the option of hiring help, but me being imogodo that I am and treating myself as one, no expectations from anyone else. This was like solely the expectations that I had on myself. I thought, let me try. Let me see if I can't do this. Let me see if I can't find a system to keep the house running, to keep the house clean, and to still have time for my marriage, parenting, as well as myself. And I think I have. I found a system that I think works. And so I'm going to take it off until June and see if, do I need help? Do I need a nanny? Do I need a cleaner? Or what do I do? But for now, I'm running solo, and as exhausting as it is, I am finding a bit meaning and fulfillment from it. So yeah, I'm still a stay home mom, and I finished my master's, graduated in December. So that is off my schedule for the time. No more being a student. But guys, knowing me, I'm probably going to be bored as soon as the system works, as soon as I find a bit more energy, and I might enroll for like maybe a short course. Last year I did that in between my master's. I registered for a research course via Verts, and it was like 6 weeks program. It was amazing. And so I might just look up what other short courses they have, solely because I do get bored and I do need entertainment in the academic brain side of who I am. But yeah, that's the one part. And the second part is, Luaga is almost two. I found the theme for her birthday, and I found the cake design that I want. I found a cake maker. And now all that needs to happen is just a few more little logistics here and there, and decide whether or not I'm going big or I'm not going big. Especially since now we're on level one, there's much more spaces to like look at, and much more options basically to do. But I'll see, but ways that will still be safe for our children, as well as the families that I might invite or might not invite, because we do still have COVID. And yeah, so I'm excited about planning that. And the other thing is, guys, I'm turning 30 in June. I don't know what I want to do. The top option now on my list is skydiving. I think I might just skydive. There's that, or I hold a dinner for some of my friends here in East London and we just have like a night of chilling and yeah, mingling and having conversations. So those are my two options, but the winning one so far is jumping off a plane. So if you've got any ideas, that stuff that I could do, like something adventurous, something exciting, and that will not break my pocket, please leave a comment down below and I'll see if I take that option. And yeah, so that was that's the personal side. And business wise, I am adding more, how can I put this? Adding more roles or titles in the work that I already do, like my side hustles. I want to explore and sort of like use all my skills and see if I can monetize some of the things that I'm very good at that I haven't really put a price at. But I'll probably let you guys know, because most of my goals in 2021 revolve around finance. It's about savings, about spending those savings, and it is about growing financially and growing the muscle of how to use funds in a way that is strategic, in a way that is and wise. And I already have planned, there will be like a week where I bring a friend of mine who is extremely good at finance and stuff, where she'll come talk to us about side hustles, how to monetize our skills, saving, investments, all those things that relate to financial literacy, because it's something that as stay-at-home moms, as single moms, and as women in general, that I think we need to start learning more about how to manage our finances, where to save, how to save, what are some of the investment options, and what do we do with the money after we've saved, because you don't want to just blow it eventually, which I don't mind blowing money. It's like one of my favorite things to do, by the way. But yeah, so, and my other goal this year is to not buy clothes, guys. Like when I was looking at the statements at the end of the year, I do that. Like I download all my statements, bank statements, and look, where's my money going? I realized I spend a lot of money on clothes and then I give them away because I either get over them I see someone who is in need of the clothes more than I do. So I've decided now that I'm gonna use what is in my wardrobe. So for the year of 2021, please pray with me. I'm not going to be buying clothes. I'm going to be saving that money instead and use it in December for something worthwhile and something that will not be wasteful at the end of the day. So yeah, those are some of the goals. What else? There's a work that I need to do around the house and I'm still building at home. And oh, an exciting project that I'm doing, the shoes. Remember I told you guys that I was collecting shoes for disadvantaged children? So on Thursday this week, on the 5th of March, we are going to go deliver those shoes. So we have two schools. We had three schools, but the third one we're now only going to deliver in June, just in time for winter, so that kids have shoes for the winter season and throughout the year. So on Thursday, I'm going to be taking you guys with me. I'll vlog the experience. And I'm very excited about that. And again, thank you to each and every one of you who donated money and who donated shoes for this project to continue. I am absolutely and eternally grateful for your help and for your contribution. We're going to continue this, but for the next year, I have a different plan, of which I will let you guys on as the year continues in terms of what are we doing the following year for the same children, or are we adding more children on the list. Yeah, so that's what's been happening and that is what I'm currently busy with. And obviously God has been so amazing in terms of giving me ideas on what to do. And again, I think I did record this last year where God was hammering in my head that I needed to know exactly what was on my hands and how was I using it. And this year he sort of amplified the message again and added that in order for me to move from the places that I'm in order for me to irrigate the poverty in my family and in my generation, all that's needed is here. I am his instrument. So it's been a few weeks of learning, how do I do that? How do I use my skill in a way that is beneficial for my family as well as my community? And how do I use it to become a millionaire? Because that's the plan, guys. So yeah, and our business, Sejosengoe, is the photography business. It's up and running. So if you've got a photo shoot, an event, birthday, baby shower, or anything, and you'd like to hire a photographer, you should know that Sejosengoe is available. And please follow us on Instagram. It's Sejosengoe. And I'm trying to grow that community so that our work is out there, so that you guys see the work that we do. And if it's something that you like, you can always just book us. We've got a few competitions coming up, and we've got a workshop coming up, but I will speak to you guys about that later on, because this workshop is on the 1st of April. And the giveaway, we're giving away, should I say it? In fact, let me say it. We are going to photograph your wedding. Obviously there are terms and conditions, because it is a competition, and we didn't limit it to a location, being in East London. We are welcome if you are doing it in Joburg, Cape Town, as long as we see it as an adventure that is worthwhile to take, we'll come and do your wedding for free. But as again, I will announce all the details on our website as well as our Instagram page as time goes. So yeah, I think that's it, guys. It's so good to be back. I've enjoyed this, and yeah, so if you're not following me on Instagram, please do. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please join the family of YouTube Center and let's grow this channel. I think I'm done, so I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.